First story is titled, Am I the a-hole for hacking my mom's Instagram to see if she violated NDA? I'm a nanny for a high-profile family. I signed a very extensive and strict NDA. Anyone directly involved in my life, mom, dad, sis, and husband, also signed an NDA. The nanny family recommended this, to talk about the job without getting into any legal trouble or putting them at risk. Recently ran into one of my parents' neighbors, Amber, at the park. Amber asked how the new job was going, then proceeded to ask specifics about how it must be, working for a family where their parents are, insert their jobs here. A direct violation of the NDA and something I could be fired and sued for. My dad isn't the sharing type, like, at all, so I figured it was probably my mom. I asked her about it in a casual, hey, how's Amber, way. I said, I ran into Amber at the park and that it was odd because she knew the details about my job without me telling her. My mom simply shrugged and said, that's funny. Maybe she Googled? Or saw something on social media? My dad and sister absolutely hate Amber. They essentially said, hell would have to freeze over before they spoke to her willingly. My dad ended our convo, where I asked him about it by saying, the only thing I know about her is that her son just made a partner at a law firm in New York and is making bank. And that's only because mom saw it on Instagram and told me about it. Right then, I knew my mom lied to me, and it was her. She and Amber love to one-up each other with their children's success, and I also just landed a great new job. I asked my mom about it again, and she told me that I was being dramatic, making stuff up, and that she would never do that to me. My mom doesn't text people, only DMs on Instagram. I know her password, so logged in to check her messages. There was an extremely long DM to Amber, where she shared their professions, children's names, ages, private school, general locations of their homes, how they pay really well, etc. Everything that we are legally not allowed to say, she said. I called her immediately and said that I logged into her DMs and saw the message she sent Amber that was a violation. She started screaming at me about how she is supposed to be able to trust her daughter. She can't believe I hacked into her Instagram, that mothers should be allowed to brag about their children, and then she hung up. It has been a week without contact between the two of us. We used to speak every single day. I am starting to believe that maybe I'm the a-hole here for violating her trust like that. My husband says if anyone violated trust here, it is her, and that I gave her ample opportunity to tell the truth before I intervened and sought out the truth myself. He constantly reminds me that they could sue us into the ground and fire me for endangering my nanny family's well-being. Because truthfully, Amber could easily be a psycho fan or sell the information to someone who is. So, am I the a-hole? Now for the top comments. Not the a-hole. Your mom crossed the line and could end up costing you your job. I would be livid. And it could put the kids at risk if they're high profile enough that the nanny's whole family had to sign NDAs and info on them is private enough that it could be sold to the media. Not the a-hole. I would recommend a CYA and tell the family what your mom did and how you responded so that they know you didn't have anything to do with it. Honestly, if I were OP, I'd consider telling them what happened and how you have handled it, and also tell them to take her to court for breaking the NDA. Unless mom gets some consequences for what she did, she'll just keep doing it. That's the part that kills me. She should face consequences because she's a grown adult and should know better. She's also my mom, though, you know? Hard to separate the two. Honestly, I doubt I'll lose my job because of my mom sharing the info. There's a stipulation about how I can share any information pertaining to my job, with the exception of work or health-related issues, with those who also signed an NDA, aka my mom, husband, dad, and sis. That way, I can have someone to vent to. Technically, my mom violated her NDA, I didn't violate mine. It's the violation of trust with a family that might get me fired because someone I love betrayed them. That's hard to cope with. If I get fired for that, then I'll understand. I love the family / kids and just want what's best for them. If that's not me because of this, then I'll accept it. Now for the next story. Am I the a-hole for not visiting my sister when she named her newborn after my deceased son? This has been going on for some time. My wife, female 29, and I, male 34, lost our son when he was only 6 weeks old. It was devastating because this was our first baby together. My wife had multiple miscarriages, and we prayed for this pregnancy to work and be healthy, but all of that ended when his soul left on May 2020. Though we didn't get to spend so much time with him, we miss him dearly. My wife says he had my nose, which she thought was cute. She talks about him in details like she still sees his face clearly. There are just so many emotions we're dealing with, but I try to keep myself busy with reading poems and talking to people with similar experiences. My family is in the picture, they visit all the time, but I've got no contact with my sister because she was disrespectful of me and my wife and showed no support in the middle of our struggle. She kept saying that something was wrong with my wife, made backhanded comments about how it was our fault and that we should get right with God and ask for forgiveness. She used the fact that my wife's first miscarriage was deserved since she was pregnant before we got married. Then, right after my son's death, while my sister was pregnant with her second child, she told us she'd name her baby after our son. This hurt my wife so much I told my sister no, and she clearly was just doing it out of spite. But she got my parents involved, saying she wanted to honor our son's memory and ended up going no contact after I was put under a lot of pressure from my parents. She gave birth to her baby this past week. My parents were visiting and told us that I should work things out with my sister, saying she meant well and that she named her son after ours to honor him. My wife started crying and went inside a bedroom. I was so mad. I told them my sister was just trying to do this out of spite, but they told me that I was being bitter and ungrateful and saw nothing wrong with having a replacement grandbaby. My wife is upset since my sister used our son's name to honor him when she doesn't even respect us. She never said sorry nor tried to fix the situation and is now using my son's name to get back at me for cutting her out. The whole family are saying that I should visit her with my wife and act like we're happy family. They've been telling me that I'm starting to look bad and that I should fix my relationship with my sister soon. My mom didn't stop insisting and is now talking to my wife who's feeling uncomfortable with this whole situation. Now, for the top comments. Not the a-hole. I hate it when people do that. The whole lot of them deserve to get cut off and know exactly why they're getting cut off. Your parents are a-holes for not even trying to talk her out of this spitefulness. Replacement grandbaby? That's so messed up. Edit. The moment you say it's honor after being told no is just to be spiteful. No other way about it. Honor is when there is consent. The parents didn't consent to it. You make an excellent point. Still balking at replacement baby too. WTF. Not the a-hole. If she truly just wanted to honor your son, she would have respected your wishes not to name her kid after him. There are so many things a godly person can do to show respect for the deceased. She could have made a donation in his name to a charity that researches his cause of death. She could have added his name to a prayer list. She could have purchased a star and named it after him. Above all, she could have shown some decency and respect to you, his parents. Yes, my parents say that my nephew doesn't deserve to be treated like this, but it's my sister I have a problem with, and they can't expect this to go away with a simple visit. Now for the last story. Am I the a-hole for giving my son's girlfriend a list of requirements if they're going to receive financial support from me after I was given a list of requirements to see their baby? I'm 49 female and I have a son 21 male and his girlfriend 21 female. His girlfriend is pregnant and because they're in a rough patch, both of them also dropped out of school. I've been helping them out with money. For the most part, I like his girlfriend well enough, but she's been a bit overbearing during this pregnancy. Not that I really blame her. Today, they came over, and his girlfriend decided to give a list of do's and don'ts to my husband and I if we wanted to have a contact with their child. The list was mostly reasonable. Have vaccines, don't swear around a baby, handle baby with care, don't show up unannounced, no sexism / racism and any sort of ism around a kid, etc. Some of them were a bit overbearing. When the baby is older, no tickling or sweets, nor cartoons, no baby talk, etc. I took issues with this for two reasons. One, it seems insulting and condescending. Some of the items on the list are things we would never do, like the racism and sexism one, struck me as really odd. We're also not anti-vaxxers. It feels like she was pretty much assuming the worst of us. Example, of course, we wouldn't swear like a sailor around a child. And we always call before we visit. They show up unannounced more than us. 2. Some of the items on the list are extreme. I understand that these are her rules and how she plans to raise the baby. But the idea that I would lose access to my grandchild because I bake cookies with them is extreme, and I don't want to walk on eggshells or go through the hurt of losing my grandchild. Especially since I feel like it's the grandparents' job to spoil the child. Within reason, of course. To clarify, I understand how these requirements could be necessary. If we weren't suited to be around children, I would understand. So, in response, I said fine. But now, here's a list of requirements to receive financial support. In the past, we've always trusted them and given them a monthly allowance. As long as we didn't think they were deceiving us or blowing money or asking for even more. We let them do what they will with the money. So, I added the stipulations like wanting to see their budget to ensure they didn't 1. Eat out 2. Buy unnecessary clothing 3. Didn't go to hair salons instead of barbers 4. Had to spend a certain amount on the baby 5. Didn't buy hobby-related stuff, etc. And finally, financial support would be lost if we were to be denied access to the baby. There were more stipulations, but I'm sure you get the point. I made this list and gave it to both of them in exchange for the list of the baby requirements. Both my son and his girlfriend were upset with this. I said that previously, I had trusted them. But since you didn't trust us, we wouldn't trust them. I also told them how disrespectful I thought they were for giving me a list when they rely on my husband and I for support. His girlfriend said I wouldn't be able to see the baby. I told them they could leave. My husband and I are both conflicted over this, and I'm wondering if I overreacted. Am I the a-hole? Now for the top comments. Wow, not the a-hole. And frankly, I love your reply. The fact that they started with, if you want any contact, you will do the following, is this wonderful thing called blackmail. You know who it's a bad idea to blackmail? The people already financially supporting you. Play stupid games. Not the a-hole. OP, you are doing it right. The couple are just choosing beggars. Info. Is it possible that girlfriend's parents are much less trustworthy than you? So a list was drawn up that applies to both sets of grandparents to be fair. My son's girlfriend has very little contact with her parents from what I can tell. So, I don't think this was a general list for both of us, but I suppose it's possible. Edit. To all of you who are sending me messages hoping I die and saying you're happy I'll never see my grandchild or calling my daughter-in-law a slut for having an accidental pregnancy, why don't you say those things in the comments instead of hiding in my inbox? Edit 2. I thought I would add a mini update. It looks like the very top reply is NTA, but there is a great deal of ESH and YTAs. I can acknowledge that a discussion would have been a better approach. However, at the time, I felt like I had just been slapped in the face, which is why I reacted the way I did. I have had some time to reflect, but right now, I am still more upset that in response to conflict, my daughter-in-law and son both reacted by saying, I will never see their child. I can possibly forgive them for the list as being overly cautious parents, but I'm not going to tolerate them threatening no contact over any conflict or using it as a control method. It would be too hurtful for myself. Some of you have accused my list as being petty, which maybe it was, but truly, I was being defensive more than anything. I will not leave myself open to emotional manipulation, and I plan on making that very clear to my daughter-in-law. I do plan on talking to my son and daughter-in-law and going from there. I'm just going to wait though, as I want to be in a clear frame of mind and right now, I am still very hurt and angry at them. Hopefully in a day or two, we will be in a position where we can all apologize to each other and move on. Thank you for the advice. And that's the end of this video, folks. As always, leave a comment and hit like and subscribe. And if you want more of this content, turn your notification on to get updated on the latest videos. And I'll catch you in the next one. Stay safe.